We begin in the house in which Mary was raised, Galbertstown, as it is today, with Tommy Gleason and family.
Congratulations on your 100th birthday. Wish you many more.
Happy birthday, Auntie Mary.
Of course they'd know me.
Wish you a very happy birthday. This is Eileen Caesar from Galbertstown, and I live here. I think you used to visit here, lived here for a while. So I wish you a happy birthday. Dennis isn't here to wish you a happy birthday. That's it. What else?
That's lovely. Oh, no.
A view of Killock Hill, which Mary was familiar with, looking out through this window from the Caesar's house. Short trip to Thurles Station, which was the start of a much longer journey to America. Today we take the same trip from Galbertstown to Thurles Station. was in this very station Mary met the man who was to journey with her to America and become her future husband. Gleason is still a strong name in Thurles. This is the new church dedicated to St. Joseph and St. Bridget. It was opened in 1971. Back towards the town centre through Parnell Street, formerly called the New Road. The square as it is today. Down on Thurles Square is Dr. Croke. His memorial was unveiled in 1978. This is Hayes's Hotel, where the GAA was founded in 1884. Roaches, a busy shop in Thurles with clients both at home and away.
century.
Hello, Mary. How are you? Mrs. Leeson. We'd like to wish you a very happy 100th birthday and all the joys that go with it. You remember in 1980 buying this piece of glass here. I'm just looking at the book here. It was £215 then. It's £530 now. I'd say that was a good buy then. All the best, Mrs. Leeson.
The old castle still stands and marks the bridge to the eastern side of the town. Pheasant Island, a new addition to Perlis Town. Not far from the bridge is Thurles Cathedral. Completed in 1871, it has held its beauty throughout the years. The residence of Archbishop Dermot Clifford is next to the cathedral. And across the road is St. Patrick's College, opened in 1837.
Hello, Anna. This is Tom Maloney, wishing you a happy birthday.
Congratulations, Mary, on your 100th birthday.
Congratulations, Mary, on your 100th birthday.
Congratulations, Eileen and family for doing such wonderful work.
Congratulations, Aunt Mary, on your 100th birthday. And I wish you many, many more. Now,
I'll say it. Congratulations, Aunt Mary. I'd love if you were here tonight to see. Of course, you'll see us over there. See Mikey here posing and he's trying to put his arm around me. It's about 50 years since he put his arm around me. I don't know whether that sounds sense or not.
And Mary, do you see President Kennedy over here? Remember that? Got in Malay's shop in Thurles. You brought it with you.
It was a present from President Kennedy when Jacqueline was born. It's a Jacqueline, the child was born. Her daughter was born. She got a present of that from President Kennedy. It was on the stair the time he came home. She got the photo taken a few years before that and it was left up in the stair office. And when President Kennedy came to Ireland, this was the photo they put on the stair for Thurles, for Tipperary, you know. It was lovely too, we still have it.
Hello, Aunt Mary. Kitty here. I'm sorry now that you've missed Dick, but he's just gone over to the pub for a pint. Anyway, on behalf of the two of us, I wish you a great 100th birthday, and I hope you'll be celebrating many more of them. There's not really a lot to say. It's just a pity that Eddie's not around to be with you on that day. And what more can I say? Everybody here is fine.
Hello, ma'am. Hope you're keeping well. Great to get a chance to talk to you. We're all in good form here.
Yeah.
Hope all the family are keeping well.
Yeah.
It was great to hear Eileen.
Well, Mom Gleason, it's like old times here. I suppose you recognise the room we had the hoolie here the night when you were home from America. And we had a wonderful night, and poor old Fitzy and Josephine were here, and we had a marvellous night. We still talk about the traditional music and the songs, and so we're delighted to get this opportunity to talk to you in person. And I was speaking to Eileen on the phone, and she told me about your birthday, and we're all thrilled here for you. The only thing we're sorry is that you couldn't make one more old trip home to the old country. Everyone here would be delighted to see you. I met Philly Dwyer, your old friend, the other evening, and he was asking for you, and I was telling him about it was your birthday. So he said to send you his best regards. And I don't know what more, I don't know, can I think of anything else
wish
now?
You good health.
But anyway, I'm delighted to get the opportunity to wish you a very happy birthday. And you're a marvellous woman. And it was a pleasure knowing you and meeting you and being in your company. So goodbye and God bless.
Sure, it is.
Okay. Hello, Mary.
Hello, Mary.
May I wish you a very happy birthday from all our family here.
And a very happy belated birthday to you. I hope you're keeping well, Mary.
And all your family. And that you may enjoy many more years to come.
We're here now at the Spiral House, if you can remember.
Gosh, Mary was hardly ever here.
I think you were here, Mary. I don't really remember whether you were actually in this bungalow or not.
Yeah.
Or was it the other bungalow down in Loch na Fulla?
And Mary, I'll bring you back a few years since the night I took you up to Drumbane. When you said to me, praise the bitter Jesus, will we ever get to Drumbane? Will we ever get to Drumbane? She says to your sister Jack, the Lord have mercy on him. Them are the words I'll never forget. I had the old banger. The old banger, as you called it yourself. And you said, how are we ever going to get back home to Thurles again, this gadget of you? Mm-hmm. Now, Mary, Jack was here just a few years ago. And his wife was very interested in greyhounds. And she picked out this bitch here. at 14 months old, and another dog with him. They were brother and sister. It's just something, oh, Mary, that I'd like to tell you, that pass on to Jack's wife. She was very interested in this bitch. And actually, she was going to buy him. But this bitch went on to win the English Oaks and was one of the best bitches that ever went over to, from Ireland, over to England. And her brother broke the track record in three or four tracks in England. So tell Jack's wife, she slipped up. Tell Jack's wife she slipped up. Yes. But she'll have to be like, well, what do you say, ma'am? Oh, yes. And Mary, all our family are all away now. The eldest lad, Micheál, is a chef in Aer Lingus. Elder is nursing in Bristol. Anna's married in Dublin. And Brian is still at the goldsmith. Yeah. Come on, ma'am. Say a few words there yourself.
I haven't done anything now.
And God bless all your family.
Yes. Yeah. I think she wanted it.
Sure, what else can I say, sure. Mary, Kitty, I'm sure you well know. You've been speaking to her many times. She has lost her only son in an accident, a farm accident there very recently. And her husband died 3 weeks after with a heart attack. So all the farm has been sold. And actually, it's gone, sold. And she's leaving, coming up to Tullis. So Mary, that's how Kitty ended up in our little farm. And it is all over. I was going to tell her my yarn, but I won't tell her anything about it. Will I?
Okay.
Yeah. Mary, there was a man up the mountain, Mary. And he was going for a rail livery job, Mary. Mary. And this man, you had to have good connections, Mary, to get this job. And he went in for this interview, into Hayes's hotel, Mary. And this man was all talk. And the man who was interviewing him told him that unless you have good connections for this job, you have no point in going for it. What are you talking about, he says to him. Sure, I'm secretary of the Holland Club. I'm treasurer of the Domestic Society. And I'm secretary of the Holland Club. Oh, he said, that's exactly what we want, he says. A man to mix, he says, when you're collecting money, you see. So he says, I'll ask you a little question, he says. If you bought a goat for £20, he says, and sold the goat again and got 5% of the herd you had, would you ever repeat that question, says to him? See? Certainly, he says, if you bought a goat for £20 and sold the goat again and 5% of what you have. Listen, he says, all the farmers of my country, says, I know every goat is in it, he says, and they're as big as asses, and you can buy the fuckers for £1, he says. So that's it. Their father, Harry Regan Bob, holds the world record for straight win, 32 straight wins. And their mother bred the winner at England. At English Oaks, rather, at English Oaks. And she also bred the winner of the championship sweepstakes. Their mother now. We actually... I didn't bother taking them out, man. They're all right.
I'm just
going.
This is it, when young, Poppy. He raced twice. Actually, he races Saturday night. Oh, no, Tuesday night.
Tuesday night.
Tuesday night, he's there.
He's racing next Tuesday night, and
he's probably well bred now, this
What's
one.
His name? I've never been to the race.
Ryan's Jewel. He's 86 pounds weight. It's very big for a great one now, 86. He's a pet named Snow.
Their father. Their
father. Holy Cross Abbey was founded by Donacha Carbrach O'Brien, King of Limerick in 1209. The Abbey, now renovated, celebrates many novenas to Our Lady throughout the year. It is here, in one of the side altars, Mary's father was buried. Opposite the altar, a deer hunting scene was discovered on the walls of the abbey.
Mary, This is the Kennedy family here in Drumbad.
Hi, Aunt Mary. I am Conor. Happy birthday.
Ellen.
Hi, Aunt Mary. I'm Eamon. Happy birthday.
Hello, I'm Marie, and I hope you have a lovely birthday.
Hi, Aunt Mary. I'm Frida. Happy birthday.
I'm Connie Kennedy. It's when I remember you, Aunt Mary. Happy birthday. Here in Drumbane.
Hello, Aunt Mary. We're all here in Drumbane. Wish you a happy birthday.
Hello, Aunt Mary. Happy birthday. From Aunt Kennedy in Drumbane.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Aunt Mary. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Mary.
Aunt Mary.
Happy birthday, Mary.
Happy birthday, Mary. Hope you're good. Now and all the grand days we had together here in Drumbane. Oh, our walk was there.
We wish you a very nice birthday, and we pray for you each night. And that was a lovely photograph, the last one we had from Eileen. You were playing the mouth organ, and the dog was sitting at your feet. Very lovely photograph that was. And you look so young in it, Mary. Yes, you did. That's all I have to say now.
Hello, Aunt Mary. Glad to hear you're keeping so well, and wish you a very happy birthday and many more of them. And remember us to all your family.
And God bless.
And God bless.
On the way to Rose Green, we stopped to look at the Rock of Cashel.
Hope you have a lovely 100th anniversary. This is Cece here from Rose Green. That all?
The dog.
Huh? What's the dog's name? Oh, this is my pet dog, Trixie. Trixie.
Hello, Trixie.
He's only a small pup, you know.
Hello, my name is Michael Power. I live in this place here, and I'm a grandson of Tom Sheehan. My mother is Bernie Power, my father is Paddy Power. I'm 16, I'm doing the leaving this year. Happy birthday, anyway. I don't know what in God's name possessed you to start taking pictures of this place, but oh God, I hope you enjoy it anyway. But,
hello, I'm Mike Sproer. I'm Bernie Power's son as well. I'm 15. I done the intro last year. I'll be doing leaving next year. Happy birthday anyway. And no more to say really. Goodbye.
Hello again. The reason that we're here instead of my mother and father is that they're both gone away, and on their behalf, we'd like to wish you a happy birthday from them. So, I'm sure they're sorry that they're not here, because if they knew that this was happening, I'm sure they'd tried their best to be here. But I'm just sorry. Their apologies for not being here. And yes, have a lovely day. Thank you. Jeez.
And I'm going to the Feather School, and I'd like to wish you a happy birthday, and I hope you have a nice day. Hello, Auntie Mary, I'm Helen, I'm Anne's sister. I go to Nanny Little School. I'm 10, and I'm in fourth class. I wish you a happy birthday.
Happy.
I'm Noel. I'm doing pre-employment course with Hazel's at Bookmakers. I'm 16 years old.
Wish you a happy birthday.
I wish you a happy birthday. Beautiful day. Lovely.
Lovely.
Hello, Auntie Mary. I'm Patrick, and I'd like to wish you a happy birthday. And I'd like to wish you a happy birthday from my older brother Thomas. I'm in leaving cert, and I'm 18 years of age. I hope you enjoy your birthday. I live in Fair.
Uptick.
Okay. Hello, Auntie Mary. This is Pauline. I'm a daughter of Tom Sheehan in Feathert. I'm standing here on my back lawn, and I hope that you will like my lovely yellow flowers, lovely tree here to the left of me. I have another beautiful flower there, but we'll get to that again. I want to wish you a very happy birthday. Here beside me is Tom. Tom comes from Schlievenemann up to the very tip-top. That's where I met him about 25 years ago. We have 6 children. The eldest isn't here now. He's out working on a farm with his uncle. I want to wish you a very, very happy birthday. It's a pity that I can't actually remember ever meeting you, but I hope that you have a lovely day, and I'm sure that you look very, very like Grandma Sheehan. I'd love to be in America now with you when you're celebrating your 100th birthday, but I'm afraid it's totally impossible. I'd love to, for Eileen, to write to me or something like that. I ring my sisters often down in Albany, and they're often talking about you, plus all the Gleasons and Thurles and in New York and the whole lot. I hope you have a lovely day from your grandniece, Pauline.
I wish you a very happy birthday. That's all I'd say.
Probably. Yeah, just.
I'd like to meet my friend Gwen, who lives next door to me.
Hello. I hope you have a lovely birthday, and I live next door to Anna and Anne's sister Helen, and we have great fun every day.
Leaving his old true love behind, perhaps a seen no more. It's a crossing of the Atlantic foam. Sometime their graves are made. So stay at home and do not roam from your bonny Irish maid. And then these sweethearts together so fondly did embrace. Like honey drops upon the dew, the tears ran down our face. Saying there's not a day while you're away, but I'll visit still these days. Until you do return again, dear bonny Irish maid.
And he'll soon begin to wonder what he ever saw in you. But he'll take without complaining all the dishes you provide. For you see, he has to have his bit of jam tarts on the side. So don't get married, girls, it's very badly paid. You may start up as a mistress, but you'll end up as a maid. Be a daring deep sea diver, be a polished polyglot. But don't get married, girls, cause marriage is the plot. Have you seen him in the morning with a face that looks like dead? With dandruff on his pillow and tobacco on his bread. And he needs some reassurance with his cup of tea in bed. Cause he's worried about the mortgage and the bald patch on his head. And he's sure that you're his mother, lay his head upon your breast. So you try to boost his ego, iron his shirt and warm his vest. You get him off the work, the mighty hunter is restored. And he leaves you there with nothing but the dreams you can't afford. So don't get married, girls, men are all the same. They just use you when they need you. You do better on the game. Be a call girl, be a stripper, be a hostess, be a whore. But don't get married, girls, cause marriage is a bore. When he comes home in the evening, he could hardly spare a look. All he says is, what's for dinner? After all, you're just a cook. But when he takes you to a party and he eyes you with a frown, you know you've got to look your best. You mustn't let him down. And you're sure that you're his mother, lay his head upon your breast. So you try to boost his ego, iron his shirt and warm his vest. You get him off to work, the mighty hunter is restored. And he leaves you there with nothing but the dreams you can't afford. So don't get married, girls, and drive around a bend. The lane without a turning to the end without an end. Take a lover every Friday, take up tennis, be a nurse. But don't get married, girls. For marriage is a curse. And you get him off to work, the mighty hunter is restored. And he leaves you there with nothing but the dreams you had afore.
Thank you. Happy birthday to Mary.